In this first question, we're asked to determine which decimal is greater than 0.7. And notice all the choices here have two decimal places. So let's first start with the given decimal 0.7. If we write this as a fraction, 0.7 is equal to 7/10. But it's often easier to compare decimals if they have the same number of decimal places. So if we start with the decimal of 0.7, we can add a zero in the hundreds place value and not change the value of the decimal, meaning 0.7 is equal to 0.70. In this form, because we have a digit in the hundreds place value, we would say this is 70 hundredths. So 7/10 and 70 hundredths are equal to each other, but because these decimals have two decimal places, it's going to be easier to think of 0.7 as 0.70 or 70 hundredths. So our first decimal is 0.60, which is a fraction, would be 60 hundredths, which is not greater than 70 hundredths. Next we have 0.65, which would be 65 hundredths, which is not greater than 70 hundredths. Next we have 0.70, which again we already know is equal to 70 hundredths. And because 70 hundredths is not greater than 70 hundredths, they're actually equal, this is not our correct answer. Looking at the last choice, we have 0.75, which equals 75 hundredths. 75 hundredths is greater than 70 hundredths, and therefore 0.75 is the correct answer. Now, one thing I do want to point out here is that we should have recognized right away that these first two decimals are not going to be greater than 0.7, because 0.7 has a 7 in the tenths place value. Notice these two decimals only have a 6 in the tenths place value. There's no way these first two decimals would be greater than 0.7. So we should be able to save some time and quickly eliminate these first two choices. Then it comes down to 0.70 and 0.75, and we already know that 75 hundredths is greater than 70 hundredths, which is equal to 7/10. Now for our second example, we're asked which decimal is less than 0.3. So if we were to say 0.3, we would say this is equal to 3/10 as a fraction. And again, because most of these decimals have two decimal places, if we take 0.3 and add a zero to the hundredths place value, these two decimals still have the same value, but now we can say that 3/10 is equal to 30 hundredths. So looking at our first decimal, we have 0.30, which is equal to 30 hundredths. 30 hundredths is not less than 30 hundredths, it's equal to, so this is not our choice. And actually you might recognize here that 0.30 is equal to 0.3, the given decimal, and therefore the two decimals are equal, the given decimal is not less than 0.3. Next we have 0.32, which is 32 hundredths. 32 hundredths is not less than 30 hundredths, so this is not correct. Next we have 0.29, which is 29 hundredths. 29 hundredths is less than 30 hundredths, and therefore this is the correct choice. 0.29 is less than 0.3. And then finally we have 0.4, which is equal to 4/10, and 4/10 is not less than 3/10, which means this is not the correct answer. But if we were to compare place values, we should be able to answer this question fairly quickly. The given decimal has a 3 in the tenths place value. Notice how of these four decimals, only one of them has a digit in the tenths place value that's less than 3. It would be this decimal here that has a 2 in the tenths place value. So very quickly, we should be able to recognize this decimal here is going to be less than 0.3. I hope you found this helpful.